It has been claimed the Queen's sister was involved in a whirlwind romance with a London gangster, which subsequently led to the infamous 1971 Lloyds bank robbery in Baker Street. The story, so it goes, begins some 4,200 miles away on the island of Mustique in St. Vincent, where the princess hosted the most outrageous parties at the unlikely royal residence. There, she was famously pictured with her unlikely lover, London gangster John Bindon. The pair were allegedly snapped in the most compromising of ways, with images eventually kept in a safe in Lloyds Bank in central London, the same bank which would be subsequently raided in the not-too-distant future. The robbery stunned the British public, who were told criminals had made an attempt to pry their way into the famous bank's vaults to get their hands on an eye-watering £500. Which would have been worth around £5 million in the early 1970s. The more dramatic truth, it has been argued, is that they were after pictures of Margaret and Mr. Bindon which had been locked away never to be seen again in a bid to protect the princess. The raid made the headlines in September 1971 and was dubbed the walkie-talkie bank job due to a tip-off from a member of the public who heard robbers communicating with one another using the devices. The images had been put in the bank by a mysterious man known only as Michael X, a criminal who had spotted the lovers on her tropical island Bolt Hole. Word got back to Princess Margaret about the pictures and a gagging order was put in place to stop the snaps ever being printed. Somehow the so-called walkie-talkie robbers discovered the whereabouts of the snaps and tried to steal them. The images were locked up as a result. Anthony Gavin, Thomas Stevens and Reginald Tucker were jailed for their part in the robbery. As for Michael X, he fled to Trinidad where he was hanged 4 years after the raid for murder. Mr. Bindon died of an AIDS-related illness in 1993, while Margaret died of a stroke in 2002. Her funeral was held at Westminster Abbey on 19 April that year.